The Egyptian hero, who almost single-handedly took his country to the 2018 FIFA World Cup, has made such an impact in the Premier League and UEFA Champions League since he traded Rome's Olympic Stadium for Anfield last year that his transfer fee of an equivalent of $68 million is already looking like a steal. Salah, who has been dubbed just about anything from the fifth Beatle to the Egyptian Messi, gave his blossoming reputation a massive boost with a mesmerising masterclass against former club Roma on Wednesday AEST. In one of the most devastating individual displays ever seen at Anfield, and there have been a few over the years, Salah scored two gems, made two other goals and clearly was the major difference between the two teams. To his credit, he also showed his class as a person and chose not to celebrate his goals out of respect for Roma and many players who were his teammates less than a year ago. So far he has scored 43 goals in 47 competitive matches for Liverpool. That's some debut season and I'd like to see his figures when he fully settles down in his new environment. Salah fully deserved the standing ovation he received when he was replaced by manager Jurgen Klopp in the 75th minute with the score at 5-0. Liverpool and Klopp owe Salah big time for a 5-2 romp that sets them up nicely for their return in Rome. Klopp's team are getting better and more confident with every round and would have to be sentimental and outright favourites to win the Continental Trophy if they hold their nerve in Roma's backyard. Contrary to the team that last won the coveted trophy in 2005 with a style of football based on dour defence, this exciting, attack-minded team no doubt would grace the final in Kiev. There is no sophistication about Liverpool's game, and I do not mean this disparagingly. There is a beautiful and effective simplicity about their forward play that is breathtaking to watch and which must be bewildering to contain. The way they tore Roma apart in the middle period of the match will have the other semi-finalists Real Madrid and Bayern Munich shaking if not trembling in their boots. How do you stop a three-pronged forward line that scores goals for fun and seems to give the impression that for every one Liverpool concede they can score two? Madrid appear to be hot favorites to reach their fourth final in five seasons after pinching a 2-1 victory in Munich. Compared to Liverpool's free-spirited play, Madrid looked ponderous and cumbersome and it must have been a frustrating night for Cristiano Ronaldo, who was well below par. How Madrid conjured such a fortuitous win at Allianz Stadium will haunt the home side for months. Even though, to their credit, Madrid scored two fabulous goals via a marvelous drive from fullback Marcelo and a superb team goal from rising star Marco Asensio. I've always been a hopeless hipster but I expect the Reds to face the Merengues in next month's final. It would be a repeat of the 1981 showdown at the Parc des Princes in Paris when Liverpool won 1-0 with a late goal from fullback Alan Kennedy. Liverpool's fans would be entitled to feel that, with Salah in such blistering form, they can dream of more European glory to go with the epic moments of the famous club's past. Follow at McCollum.